Duke's power and technique. So, okay. There's two ways to throw a punch. And one way uses only technique. And the other one uses muscle power. So the technical punch uses your tendons and the way your body moves. And the other punch relies a lot on the strength of the muscles in your body. And as you get tired, you get worn out. The slower punches, the muscle punches, take longer to throw. They tire out much more because you're using muscles as well as tendons and your body movement. You know, you don't need to use all that energy. It's a crazy amount of energy going into a punch that you just don't need to. So with Jimmy Sweeney. Now, you can see when he only has to land a punch and it has an effect, a big effect. And that's a very, very rare thing. You don't see that. I don't think I've ever seen it in any fighter, sportsman as such. I've seen a couple of street guys. Well, one street guy that I know had it, but that's two people that I've ever seen that had that sort of understanding. And they're pure technical punches. So when I talk about two punches, they could be two boxing punches. You know, when Jimmy throws a boxing punch, that's a purely technical boxing punch. It's not a power punch as such. A muscle punch. Strength punch. I think strength punch. And there's nobody in the UFC. I've not seen anybody at the moment. Connor's probably the closest. Possibly Joanna. Nobody is throwing a technical punch. Nobody. Like 100% technical punch. Because if they landed it, it'd have an effect. Now, Connor only has to land it and it has an effect, but it doesn't hurt him. Well, yeah. Got that wrong. It hurts him and he's probably one of the most effective punches there, and he's pound for pound, he's the hardest puncher there by the looks of it so far. But he's not using a purely technical punch. Crazy. So yeah, strength punch or technique punch. And what's the difference? Let's see if we can sort this out once and for all. So, a lot of people tend to think that, like with a, let's use a press. Bench press. Let's use a bench press. Now there was a study that some university did about the bench press, and they said if you do loads of bench presses, then your punching power will go up. Yeah. But does it improve the technique of the punch? Because then your punching power will go up and the energy you use will go down. So with a bench press, I'm just coming forward. So if I'm pushing sort of forward, a bench press, there's weight all the way through that, all the way through till I get to there. And I'm using my muscles to move the bench press, to press. That's what it's called. It's called a press. So I'm pressing it out. I'm not jumping or firing it out. Now, if I throw a punch, then when I land the punch on the target, then that's when there's resistance. There's no resistance here whatsoever. Whereas if I'm pushing a weight, then I'm pushing out. Different muscles for different movement, they're different shapes. But the main difference, now if I was massive and I had loads of muscles and I threw a perfect technical jab out here and I was really muscular, what would be the difference than if I was just sort of as I am now? if I was the same weight, then, and I was more stockier and sort of muscle bound, but the same weight, then I'd hit much harder as I am now. And I've never trained sort of to be a bigger size. But the difference is, now here, let's just look at, I'm just gonna do a snap and it's with a shockwave, and you'll just understand exactly what I mean. So I'm just gonna do a light snap, like the amateur sort of boxing sort of thing. Now if I throw a snap here now, now I'm hitting with the outside part of the knuckle, like a boxing punch. Now where is any strength going in there? Because all the energy is coming back this way. So if I'm using strength in this and the energy is coming back this way, then I'm pushing against myself. And just like if I was doing a jab, then I'm coming out and I'm snapping back. As I land the shot, my energy is coming back. That's when this moves forward and digs in. This is coming backwards. I'm not gaining anything from pushing my muscles, because it's technique. If I'm hitting in deeper to the target, I'm still not pressing or pushing in. I'm snapping in with technique. It's my body snapping in and coming off in a certain angle at a certain depth. But at no point am I using any strength to throw that shot out. Now the thing is with the boxing, it's a rare thing. The problem is with the gloves and the way they train, they do not train themselves. They don't isolate the snap. And they just don't get the snap. It takes years to do if you don't isolate it and train it. And I don't see anybody isolating it. I think the way a lot of the old boxers who used to punch really hard got it was on the sandbags, and there's no sandbags in the gyms anymore. And the thing is, if you hit a sandbag, then if you hit with any kind of strength, then you won't hit the sandbag again if you hit it hard without checking it. And what happens is, if you want to continue to hit that sandbag, you'll start to use pure technique, because otherwise it hurts too much. Simple as that. And yeah, you start off slow. And if you can throw a punch slow, how many people do you know can throw a slow punch? Hardly anybody, because they don't understand the technique. So there is no strength in technique. The strength is in technique. Yeah. So the bigger I am, the bigger size my arms are, the more weight I have to pull back when I hit, or the more weight I can throw in. So if I was 6 foot, athletically built like a UFC fighter, or I was 6 foot, the same weight, and really out of shape, with technique, there wouldn't be that much difference in the punch. The only difference would be a little increase in speed, because one guy would have stronger tendons. But the guy who is completely out of shape, if he understood how to throw a purely technical punch, then he could knock somebody out. He just has to land it, because it has an effect, like Jimmy's punches. So even if he was he hadn't punched for 10 years, but he'd got to that level where he understood the shock and the snap, then he could knock somebody out with a shot. That is the key. That is the answer to the one punch knockout. It's a purely technical punch. It's not the size and the weight. And I think one of the biggest things that surprised me with the with like UFC punching is the amount of energy that they put into a punch, Connor doesn't use. He tends to, his energy comes from his aggression, and he wastes a lot of it with his anger. But his punching's, he doesn't use a lot of energy in his punches because they've got really good technique. But he doesn't quite understand. He's got a lot of. He's quite sharp on the end, but he's not pointing on the end. Have you seen him hit the bob? He just didn't know. It's like he didn't really understand which part of the knuckle he was hitting with, or he was, because he didn't have wraps on and stuff. I don't know. You know, he knows which part to hit with, but yeah. So bench press is bollocks when it comes to punching technique. That's what you need.